Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Good morning,
everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Every time I go away, something happens with the microphone. Don't quite know what the visiting priest is done with the one and the one in St. Bernadette's. I've never been away again. I know you did. Anyway, that means to be back from my trip to Lourdes last week. I remember that bit of a story about the return journey, but that's for another day. Lovely to welcome the children here this morning as we gather them up together and send them out for children's liturgy. So any children who wish to go out to children's liturgy, please do so now.
So to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind this. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do,
give us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to be.
God of might, giver of every good gift, put into your hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever.
Amen.
Change, modeled by your new mind.
This is the only way to discover the will of God and know what is good, what it is that God wants, what is the perfect thing to do, the work of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus began to make it clear to his disciples that he was destined to go to Jerusalem and suffer grievously at the hands of the elders and chief priests and scribes, to be put to death and to be raised up on the third day. Then, taking him aside, Peter started to remonstrate with him. "Heaven preserve you, Lord," he said. "This must not happen to you." But he turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to my path, because the way you think is not God's way, but man's." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who wants to save his life will lose it, but anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. What then will a man gain if he wins the whole world and ruins his life? Or what has a man to offer in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and when he does, he will reward each one according to his behavior." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, for many people September rather than January is the beginning of a new year. The reason for this is that schools and universities begin a new academic year, which affects not only the academic population, but has a bearing on family life and the volume of traffic on the roads. I would like to thank our teachers, governments, ancillary staff, parents, and of course, the pupils and students for making our schools places of learning in a Christian environment. In all things, we are called to have the mind of Christ and to worship God in a way that is worthy of human beings. This September is also a time of change in our diocese. We are replacing the present 13 deaneries into 9 pastoral areas, which will be led by the dean of each particular area. The reason for this is not for a bureaucratic purpose, but to make more effective the mission of our diocese to the wider community. We are called to collaborate in this task. In this, we will discover the will of God and know what is good. Each of the pastoral areas will be named after a saint of our diocese. I hope you will be inspired by these people who have lived the Christian life in a previous time and have dedicated their lives to the kingdom of God. As well as reviewing parish pastoral councils, we need to revitalize deanery pastoral councils and the diocesan pastoral council. And on October the 7th at St. Bernadette's School, Whitchurch, there is to be a diocesan day, which we will inform and guide us with the formation of these various councils. There will be a series of group conversations. David Wells, a well-known speaker in our community, will help us to focus on the purpose of this day. The task of the councils is to identify the needs of the wider community, as well as the church community, and to respond as best they can to meet those needs. This includes chaplaincy, schools, university, hospitals and prisons. As I have said many times, if we are inward looking, we will die. But if we are outward looking, we will be changed and challenged. But we will live and know that we are being faithful to the gospel. The preparation for the synod on synodality, which opens in October, has shown us the importance of listening to one another. In listening, we show respect and often are enriched by what we hear. The council should be places of listening to the word of God, listening to one another, rather than promoting a particular cause or idea of what we think others should be doing or thinking. In the gospel today, Peter is not really listening to Jesus because he does not like what Jesus is saying. We too can be like Peter, wanting to hear our own words rather than the word of God, who is Jesus, who makes visible the presence of God and the Father, and the promises and the gifts of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is life to the Church and enables the mission of the Church in ways that can be unexpected. We are all disciples following Jesus and discovering the meaning of the kingdom of God. We are all learners called to deepen our relationship with God through Christ and by the power of the Holy Spirit, who renews our lives at the face of the earth. The proposed changes in our diocesan life is a continuation of what we have reflected upon in consideration of prayer, communion, and mission. The fruits of those reflections is contained within Call to be a People of Hope and parishes in communion with the mission. Pope Francis calls us to deepen our understanding of communion, participation and mission, which is similar to our reflections. I look forward to meeting some of you at the Diocesan Day. I hope to see many of you in the schools and parishes throughout the coming academic year. With my blessings, Declan, Bishop of Clifton. So as Bishop Declan mentioned, we are forming new pastoral areas in our diocese, the 13 deaneries becoming essentially 9 deaneries. And as you know, as we mentioned in our newsletter over the weeks, I will be the new dean of what was Trowbridge, but now incorporating the city of Bath, Stratton-on-the-Foss, Warminster, St. George's has gone to the Salisbury pastoral area. So watch this space to see what's happening in the future within our communities. If you do wish to go on the Diocesan Day on the 7th of October, there are still places available, but you do have to reserve a place. So please let me know if you wish to be part of that discussion on the 7th of October. And also keep in your prayers for all those who will be taking on the new dean's roles, which will be quite different to the previous ones that we've had in the past. Let us stand and profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father.
petitions before the Lord. We pray for the Church of all of us holy people, for Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, they will serve always the needs of the people of God. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let's mention the bishops, Declan's pastoral letter. Let us pray for our colleges, our schools, and all the pupils who will be returning this week. That this year may be a year of growth, a growth in knowledge and understanding, and particularly a growth in faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for our world and its many needs, for peace and reconciliation amongst the nations, that all may end and justice may come. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For ourselves and our journeys of faith, that we may walk in the footsteps of the saints and be guided always by their inspiration. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in mind or in body, for those awaiting medical procedures and those recovering from it, that they may be given the grace of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur this time. Gerard Flynn, for whom we offer this mass, they may be reunited in heaven with their loving Father. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of Heaven, to be with us and to pray for us as we say.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death.
Make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours, may we make acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
What it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power. Through Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. Lift
up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you have raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we expect. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Humbly we pray to partake in the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve in your name. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Geraldine, for whom we offer this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your peace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
The Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but shall I say to you, and my soul shall be healed.
Love it.
Let us. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity that may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our day. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just to mention that there is unfortunately no newsletter this week, as I couldn't get back from Lewis until very late yesterday afternoon. And no good prayers either. Next week, normal service will be resumed. Also, just to mention that there's no Mass on Monday morning and on Tuesday evening in the current events that I have had. And also to mention, based upon Bishop Pascual's letter, that Pascual area will be in from yesterday, is the Pascual area of St. Oliver Plunkett's, associated in our diocese with some of his remains being in Downside Abbey. So we will look at that close in more detail later in the year. Hope you all have a good week and a good week ahead. It's typical, isn't it? The storms go back and the sun comes out. Anyway, enjoy the weather. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is
thanks be to God.